So, students, I hope you all have understood that how the religious synthesis they help the people to think on a right path, think about what is right, what is wrong, what is love, what is truth, what is God, how to believe in God, okay, with the help of the bhakti movement. Yes, so we saw different santa which help the people in following all these things. So with this we have done with our third lesson, and now we will start with exercise. Is it okay? So shall we start? Please read the lesson first, all of you. Whenever the lesson is completed, please read it so that you'll find the answers. Now write the related word. See here, words are given, we have to write related words. Sri Basveshwar, Karnataka. If Sri Basveshwar has started his work in Karnataka, then from where was Mirabai? Who will tell me the answer? From where was Mirabai? Come on page number 11, you will get the answer. Mirabai, from where was she? Mewad. M E W A D. Okay, Sri Basveshwar, Karnataka, Mirabai, Mewad. Understood, all of you? Yes. Now, if Ramananda, okay, Ramananda, North India, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, from where is he? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This answer also you will get on page number 11. Just try to find it out. Open page number 11 and try to find out the answer. North Ramananda, he started his work in North India, Bhakti movement. Okay, means he strengthened the Bhakti movement in North India, Santa Ramananda. So, from where did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started his work? Yes. Did you find the answer? Yeah, you all are right. Come on. The answer is Bengal. What is the answer? Bengal. Okay. Clear. Understood? Okay. Now, Sri Chakradhar Swami. Okay. Chakradhar, Sri Chakradhar Swami, he is from Maharashtra. Do you all know this? Yes. Why? Because it is given on page number 12. Okay. Sri Chakradhar Swami from Maharashtra. Okay. M A Okay, so Chakradhar Swami, Maharashtra. Now tell me, from where is Shankara Deva? Come on. Shankara Deva, where did he started his work? Where did he started the Bhakti movement? They all started the Bhakti movement in these different places. Sri Basveshwar, Karnataka, Mirabai, Mewad, Ramananda, North India, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bengal, Chakradhar Swami, Maharashtra, Shankara Deva. Yes. Come on, class. Assam. Where did he started the Bhakti movement? Assam. Understood? Okay. Clear. Did you got everyone? Got the answer? Please write the answers in your textbook. and also complete the exercise. Next, make a chart to show the people and works related to. Okay, so you are going to make this chart like this. Make a chart to show the people and works related to Bhakti movement, Mahanubhu Panth Sikhism. Now you can make the chart in your own way also, but see here, I have given the chart, Bhakti movement, Ramanuja and other acharyas strengthen the base of Bhakti movement in South India. Why? Because it started first in South India. They preach values like love to God, humanity, companion, mercy, etc. Okay, what did Bhakti movement taught? That I have given you in the second column. And who started it? Who spread it? Getting all of you? So you will make like these columns, and if you have any other idea, you can do in that way also. Then Mahanubhu Panth. Shri Govinda Prabhu was the guru of Chakradhar Swami, and he mainly spread the Mahanubhu Panth, teachings of Mahanubhu Panth. Okay, so Shri Govinda Prabhu, okay, was guru of Chakradhar Swami. And what does this sect preaches? This sect preaches devotion to Krishna, only believing in Krishna. Okay, so the people have that right that they can choose their own way. Next is Sikhism. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism. Yes, and follower of Sikhism or followers of Guru Nanak are known as Sikhs. Yes, do you remember? So, Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism. He taught that all persons should be treated equally. So, this is how you are going to make the chart. Clear class? This is question number 2, and this is the answer which I had given you all. So please write this down properly in your notebooks. Next, write about in your own words. Now this answer you'll find it in the textbook itself. Sant Kabir became a renowned Sant in the Bhakti movement. Why did Sant Kabir became so renowned in the Bhakti movement? That you have to write. Okay, so all of you just see page number 11. I'm not going to tell you the whole answer, just mark the answer. Page 11. All of you, page 11. You can see the picture of Sant Kabir, that paragraph only. The line, leave the line, Sant Ramananda strengthened the Bhakti movement in North India. Don't write, mark your answer. Sant Kabir is a well-known Sant in the Bhakti movement. Mark it down, all of you. Page number 11. He did not attach any importance to places of pilgrimage, vratas or idol worship. For him, truth was God. What was God? Truth was God. He taught that all human beings are equal. Please write the answers in point so that it is very much easy for you all to learn the answer. He did not believe in any differences based on caste, creed, sect and religion. He wanted to bring about Hindu and Muslim unity. He criticized the extremely orthodox people in both Hindu and Muslim religion in strong terms. So, Sant Kabir became a renowned Sant in the Bhakti movement. You will write the answer like this. Everybody got the answer? Page number 11. From Sant Kabir till in strong terms. It is very short answer. Okay, just write the answer as it is and learn it. Understood, everyone? Means why Sant Kabir became a renowned? Why did he become famous? Why people know knew him more in the Bhakti movement. So this is your answer. You'll write it. Okay.